If we're coding AI and we understand that there's moral consequences, does that mean the programmer has to understand it, right? It isn't only the programmer, although we do really think that we need to train programmers to be watching out for these kinds of situations, knowing how to whistleblow, knowing when to whistleblow. There is a problem of people being overreactive, and that costs companies, and I understand that. But we also have sort of a Nuremberg situation that we need everybody to be responsible. But ultimately, it isn't just about the programmers, right? The programmers work within the context of a company, and the companies work in the context of regulation. And so it is about law, it's about society. One of the papers I had come out in 2017 with Professor Alan Winfield was a thing about how if legislatures can't be expected to keep up with the pace of technological change, what they could keep up with is which professional societies do they trust. And then you could have basically, and they already do this in various disciplines, it's just new for AI. You say you have to achieve the moral standards of at least one professional organization. So when they give like their rules about what's okay. And that sort of allows you kind of a loose coupling, because it's wrong for professional organizations to enforce the law, to go after people, to sue them, whatever. That's not what professional organizations are for. But it's also sensible that it is what professional organizations are for, is to keep up with their own field and to set things like codes of conduct. And so that's why you want to bring those two things together, the executive government and the professional organizations, and you can kind of have the legislature join those two together. And this is what I'm working hard to keep in the regulations, that it's always people and organizations that are accountable, and so then they will be motivated to make sure that they can demonstrate they follow due process. So both the people who are operating the AI and the people who develop the AI. Because it's like a car. When there's a car accident, normally, the driver is at fault. Sometimes the person they hit is at fault because they did something completely unpredictable, right? But sometimes the manufacturer, did something wrong with the brakes, and that's a real problem. So we need to be able to show that the manufacturer followed good practice, and it really is the fault of the driver, or sometimes that really there isn't a fact of the matter, like it was just an unforeseeable thing in the past, but of course now it's happened, so in the future we'll be more careful. That just happened recently in Europe. There was a case where somebody was on, it wasn't like a total driverless car, but I guess it was cruise control or something. It had some extra AI, and unfortunately somebody had a stroke. Now, what happens a lot, and what automobile manufacturers have to look for is falling asleep at the wheel. But this guy had a stroke, which is different from falling asleep. So he was still kind of holding on semi in control, but couldn't see anything, hit a family and killed two of the three of the family. And so the survivor was the father, and he said he wasn't happy only to get, money from insurance or whatever, the liability or whatever. He wanted to know that whoever had caused this accident was being held accountable. So there was a big lawsuit. And that company was absolutely, it was a car manufacturing company. They were able to show they followed due process. They'd been incredibly careful. This was just like a really unlikely thing to have happened, to have that kind of stroke that you'd be holding onto the steering wheel and all these other things. And so it was decided that there was nobody actually at fault. But it could have been different. If Facebook is really moving fast and breaking things, then they're going to have a lot of trouble proving that they were doing due diligence when Cambridge Analytica got the data that it got. And so they are very likely to be held to account for anything that's found to been a negative consequence of that behavior. And it's something that computer scientists should want, that tech companies should want. They should want to be able to show that they've done the right thing. So so everybody who's ever made any code at all knows there's like two different pressures. One is you want to have clean, beautiful code that you can understand, it's well documented and everything, and that's good, because then if you ever need to change it or extend it, or you want to write some more software, right, that's great, you can reuse it, other people can reuse it, maybe you'll get famous for your great code, right? The other thing is that you want to put stuff out as soon as you can, because you can sell it faster, you don't have time, whatever, you want to go do something else. And so that's why you make, or maybe you don't even understand what you're really doing and you've just barely got it to work, right? Whatever. So those two pressures are always working on each other, right? And it's really, really important for all of our benefit, for society's benefit, that we put weight on that side of that nice clean code so we can tell questions like the one I just mentioned, questions like who's at fault if data goes the wrong place, right? So right now, that's not the way it's been going. It has been completely, you know, sort of Wild West, and nobody can tell where the data is going, right? But with a few lawsuits, with a few big failures, I think everyone's going to be motivated to say, no, I want to show that the AI did the right thing, and it was the owner's fault, or that we followed due diligence, and that was an unforeseeable consequence. You know, they're going to want to prove that stuff. And like I said, that's going to benefit not just the companies and not just the owners or operators, but all of us, because we want liability to be on the people who are making the decisions, right? And so that's the right way around. So that's why we want to maintain human accountability, even though the autonomous system is sometimes taking decisions. The thing that drives me craziest that organizations do wrong about AI right now is when they go in and try to fight regulation by saying, oh, you'll lose the magic juice. You know, like deep learning is the only reason we've got AI. And if you regulate us, then you can't use it because nobody knows what the weights are doing in deep learning. Okay, this is completely false. All right, first of all, when you audit a company, you don't go and try to figure out how the synapses are connected in their accountants. You just look at the accounts. So in the worst case, we can do the same thing with AI that we could be doing with humans. Now, again, this goes back to what I was saying earlier about due diligence. If you have accountants and the accounts are wrong, you could try to put the accountant on the stand and say, why are the accounts wrong? And then you try to establish whether they were doing the right thing at the right time or whatever. You can't do that with AI systems, but if you want to be able to prove that there were honest mistakes, you can look at, like, how was the system trained? You know, how was it being run? There's ways that you can audit whether the system was built appropriately. So I think we should be all looking for those because that also allows us to improve our systems. So the most important thing is just not believing the whole magic line. And one of the companies I've heard give the magic line in a regulatory setting, you know, in front of government representatives, was Microsoft, and that was at early 2017. And now they've completely reversed that. They've sat down, they've thought about it, and now they've said accountability and transparency is absolutely core to what we should be doing with AI. And I think Microsoft are making really strong efforts to be the adults in the room right now. So, which is interesting, like I said, just literally within 1 year there was that change. So I think everybody should be thinking that AI is not this big exception. Don't look for a way to get out of responsibility.